lab, we're mostly interested in complexity. So questions are, how does complexity arise? And it's remarkable that with all the genes and products that we have in our genome that we can develop and function fine. The organism that we are interested in, C. elegans, is relatively simple, but has all the complexity, on the other hand, that we humans have. And it's an amazing model for human biology as well as disease.
I study the nervous system in Drosophila, and I'm most interested in the development function of the nervous system with a particular emphasis on glial cells. But I'm also interested in how glia talk to neurons in the context of development and disease. So we study things like how neurons and glia talk to one another during development, and also after there's been, for example, an injury in the nervous system, how axons fall apart, signal to the glia that there's been an injury, and how glia would clear that debris from the brain.
Well, I work in here at UMass, studying developmental biology primarily, and I use C. elegans as a model system. I would say it's developmental genetics from the perspective of physiology and gene regulation.
We study autophagy, which means self-eating. All cells use autophagy, and it's important for the removal of what may be considered bad material. The importance of autophagy to human diseases is very clear. All age-associated disorders have links to defects in autophagy. So those diseases would include things like cancer and neurodegeneration.
My lab is interested in very fundamental questions about how gene expression is regulated, both during the lifetime of an organism, but also transgenerationally. And in particular, how epigenetics is involved in the control of gene expression.
One of the main advantages of studying invertebrates is the quickness that we can uncover new phenomena. The ability to spot something unexpected and follow up and uncover those unexpected and new phenomena is one of the great advantages of the invertebrate system. Almost always, observations and discoveries from the invertebrate experimental system apply to vertebrate systems.
The reason invertebrates are a great system, one of the reasons, is because you can answer questions in about 1/10 to 1/50th the amount of time. How does cell X talk to cell Y than you can in a mammal? And then you can expect, in most cases, that that mechanism is going to be conserved. Invertebrates have contributed in many fundamental ways to neuroscience, and the main reasons that you can do that, or you can do really nice work in an invertebrate, is the ability to uniquely identify specific cells over and over.
We wouldn't have a human genome sequence if C. elegans had not been sequenced, and that sequence came out in December 1998. And so all the technologies that have been developed for invertebrates, for genome sequencing and understanding the genome, have been started and pioneered in simpler organisms such as C. elegans. Also, C. elegans has been shown to be instrumental in understanding human disease and many basic cellular processes, including programmed cell death, cancer, and many others.
Most of the genes that we know are important to disease were originally discovered using genetic approaches in model organisms. Whether it's cancer or neurodegeneration, you can use model organisms to study genes that contribute to disease in humans.
I just thought that worms were really a cool system. No one had ever introduced a transgene into the animal, and I just thought this whole concept of putting genes back was of such fundamental importance to being able to understand the biology of an organism. Obviously, it's had a lot of really interesting little secrets that it was keeping from us and that we've begun to learn over the years since then.
I would really encourage young scientists, especially students starting out, to consider working on an invertebrate system, because you can do experiments quickly and learn something new quickly. You can conduct experiments, especially if they're genetic experiments, with very little cost, actually. But at the same time, pose really new and deep questions about living organisms.
We are at a very exciting time right now, because we have still so much to learn. Now, with the advent of molecular techniques and genomic approaches, now we're really at the cusp of bringing it all to fruition and really understanding the worm as a quote-unquote system.
My advice to young investigators is to follow their instinct, to find the best system to study the problems that they're interested in. And then once they make interesting observations that may go against what other people believe are facts, to follow those observations and test them rigorously in model systems, especially invertebrate model systems.
You can move your research forward much more rapidly in a model system, and yet you're studying questions that are of great fundamental importance. And you know, you should work on whatever organism is going to be the best one to solve the question that you're interested in.
We can do so much now so quickly in invertebrates that I think for many, many years are going to be leading the way in biomedical research.